Hey y'all, I'm gonna show y'all how to get these butterfly Dutch braid buns, I guess is what you can call them. So first I'm starting off with my Creme of Nature Leave-In Conditioner. I do have natural hair, so this is what I have to put on my hair just to give it like some extra moisture. Then I'm going in with my Shea Moisture Coconut and Hibiscus Styling Curl Milk. This is really going to define my waves in my natural hair, so that, you know, when I do lay my buns on top, you can still see my natural hair and it's laid, honey. Then I'm going in with my Eco Styler Gel. This is the argan oil one, and I'm just going to put that down real good, a good thick layer, just so my waves can be really defined. Brush that real good. I'm gonna get two rubber bands, just because I have natural hair and it's very hard to put your hair up in a ponytail. I'm gonna get two. You can also use a hair scrunchie, but I'm just gonna use these rubber bands to put my hair up. I'm also gonna take my edges out, that way I can already know, you know, where to lay them at. But I'm taking them with like a, what they call this, like a rat tail comb or something like that, and I'm just gonna brush it all up and put in a rubber band. Notice my part is not straight. I didn't want it super straight just because my buns are going to be over it anyway, so it's fine. Now here I'm showing you where I've already pre-made a butterfly braid, and I'm going to show you like exactly what I did to make this braid. So what I did was I took some of the hair that you get from the beauty supply stores, like $4.99, and I had just recently took this out of my head, but I was like, you know what, I think I can get one more use out of this. So I took it, I separated it into two parts, and I combed it out, and I only took like a third. Okay, you know how it's folded over? So I took a third of one part that's folded over, if that makes sense. I'm about to show y'all. So after I got that part, I cut it with scissors. Now I'm going to just take an elastic band and tie it around there real good. I think I tied it like three times. And then I took another elastic band after I tied this and tied it around my little bun that I created on my head when I put my head in a ponytail. Once I get the hair separated, I'm gonna separate it into three pieces. I'm just gonna really create a plait, and I'm gonna plait it all the way down, but not too tight so that I can't pull it apart, but we're just gonna plait it like you would a regular plait. Thank you. Once I get to the bottom, I tie with another elastic band just to make sure nothing comes down. Then I start to pull it apart. I'm pulling like the ends apart, the two edges at the end, not the little pieces in the middle, but we're pulling the edges apart. And this creates the messy butterfly Dutch braid effect. So pull it as far as you can. The messier, the better. Attach the other one, and I'm gonna attach it to the back just the same as I did the first one with an elastic band. And I try to attach it like I attached one in the back, so I try to attach one to the front, that way they're even and my two buns are like the same size. We're gonna wrap the buns and wrap the braids in the opposite direction. So I'm wrapping one clockwise and the other one counterclockwise, and I'm securing them with bobby pins. Make sure you secure your hair with bobby pins so that it doesn't fall. And I'm just securing it with the bobby pins. Then I'm gonna go in and stick the little crown jewels on my hair just to make sure I get, you know, that little gold effect. I love sticking those little things on my hair. I don't know what it is, but they just add so much spunk to my hair. Now I'm gonna go ahead and lay my edges down. I'm using the Got to Be Glue in the black bottle and a little bit of my Eco Styler gel to do this. And what I do is I press it on like the beginning of my edges. Then I take the end of the rat tail comb and I smooth it down real good. Then I take my small tooth comb and get my edges the way I wanna go, what I'm doing right now. And then I take the red tail comb and go over it again just to get like the excess gel off of there so that none of it is just like sitting up there caked up on my hair. Like this step right here is so crucial. You must do this. Even if you're not doing this step and you laying your edges, you must take the red tail comb and get the excess off of your hair. It will save you a lot of time. I promise. And here's the end result. I hope you guys liked. I love these Dutch berry buns. Like, anytime I do like space buns, everybody's always asking me like, how do you do your space buns? So y'all, this is how I do my space buns. Like, enjoy, subscribe.